proximal anastomosis tie down technique. For this procedure, you will need a piece of descending aorta and a piece of ureter. The instrument list is described in your workbook. Prepare the ureter with an oblique transection and then ask your assistant to hold the very tip of the conduit and make a backwards cut to give the desired shape and length for the anastomosis. Inspection of the conduit will reveal the lumen and the shape. To make a hole in the aorta, use a 15-bladed knife, which you will see is the same diameter as a 4mm aortic punch. Make a single stab incision in the aortic wall. Introduce the aortic punch edge first into the incision. Pull up on the punch without dislodging it. And engage the punch to create a circular, smooth hole. Pass the first arm of a 5-0 proline suture through the heel of the conduit and put to one side. Take the other arm and pass it through the aorta from inside to outside at the 12 o'clock position, as if you were looking at a clock face. Now, lower the conduit onto the aorta and secure in position with 3 throws of a knot. Pass one end of the suture underneath the conduit and secure with a shod artery clip. When performing the rest of the anastomosis, it may be helpful to think of the hole in the aorta as a face of a clock and space your sutures in the vein appropriately. The first suture passes from outside the vein to inside. And then from inside the aorta to outside at the 11 o'clock position. Continue along this segment of the anastomosis until you reach the 9 o'clock position on the clock face. You should be halfway down one side of the conduit. Stop at this point and shod the suture. Continue the anastomosis using the other arm of the suture, respecting the spacing on both the conduit and the aortotomy. The first suture will pass from outside the vein, inside, and then from inside the aorta to outside in the 1 o'clock position. continue around the anastomosis, making sure that the needle passes smoothly through the conduit and through the full thickness of the aortic wall, until you meet the previous arm of the suture. The anastomosis is secured with a knot, and cut. The anastomosis is inspected externally and then the aorta transected to enable the anastomosis to be assessed from the inside. Check for spacing of the sutures and full thickness bites, and pass a probe from inside into the conduit to confirm patency.